Alrighty, going to play some colorless Tron here today. Basically, Eldrazi Tron. It's got Thought Knots. It does not have Reality Smashers. It's a little less aggressive. No Walking Ballistas either. It's trying to control the game with Chalice of the Void, All is Dust, and then Mystic Forge to kind of go off and let you see a bunch of cards alongside Karn the Great Creator. And then, of course, four copies of Urza's Saga with a bunch of different one-off bullets and things to get out of the sideboard. So, pretty sweet deck. You got, like, Possessed Portal going. Four Spellskites as early defenders, plus ways to keep your, like, Ensnaring Bridge alive, which is a big part of your plan. So, interested to see how this deck does. Hopping in a queue right now. Welcome back, Kringlemeister, for a year-long resub. Am I going to play in the Fab Calling? I am not. I am not going to be traveling over the next couple months. So, unfortunately, going to have to miss out on that one. Don't people want to play Modern? Where are all my Modern opponents? Do I do channel point bets for the 5-0? The mods do different predictions. I don't tend to control those. Paper Magic sounds a lot of fun, Frost Daughter. I have not played Paper Magic. I guess we did Cube Draft when we rented the cabin a couple months ago, so wasn't too bad. Though it would be nice to maybe update the cube with all the last couple sets here. All right, here we go. Time to round. Oh, yeah, literally went to the pre-release. Yeah, that's true. That's true. Good call, Sponzy. All right, I would like to play first. Oh, we're playing at someone with a companion. How large is my paper collection? Fills a couple boxes, not huge. I'm doing more Flesh and Blood videos, but like the latest thing that they're kind of assigned me to is I'm doing a bunch of like talking head type videos where I like talk about different aspects of the game or different mechanics, basically stuff to run during calling coverage so we're able to kind of onboard people onto the game here. Now it's a ley line. Nope, it's a Luris. Ooh, this deck also has four Serum Powders, but I'm going to keep this hand because I get to go tower into map into power plant. And that is what we call Tron on turn three. Playing against Jund, Grixis, something. Who knows? Hey, good stuff, Progressive. Yeah, the last episode of CR was about keeping your mental game strong, and I thought it was pretty good. I enjoyed it. When did I start to play Magic? In 1994. I haven't played continuously since then, but I've played quite a bit. Squirrel here acting like I don't see him. Ensnaring Bridge? Yeah, go for it. I'm going to get to go Thought Not Seer next turn. Oh, Kruxa? Oh, it's okay. I have some good Kruxa bait here. Get out of here, Serum Powder. How many Sliver Queens do I own? I own zero Sliver Queens. Have I played Tron in a PT? I have, yes. I also top aided the first modern GP with Tron Powerline Tower. Okay, well, Blast Zone's cute, but let's go Thought Not Seer first. Take your Unholy Heat, leaving three lands. How many Unmoored Egos do I have? Besides, like, the literal one that's in my head, I think I have a couple because I played them in some tournament or whatever. Hey, thanks.
Hey, Luis. Just wanted to say a big thank you for all the entertainment over the years. I haven't always been able to catch streams and show support, but been a longtime watcher of CFB videos. Thanks for all you do for MTG.
Hey, I appreciate that. Thanks for supporting the stream and hanging out. The islands for Voidmere and Spellskite, and I don't even know what else could come up. I don't know. How many Arboreal Grazers do we have? I don't know, probably like six or something. Oh. They got a Lurrus into their hand? Sure. Ooh. I do like Urza's Saga. I think I'm gonna play that instead of playing Blast Zone. I was considering the Blast Zone. The question now is, do I play Ensnaring Bridge? I kind of feel like I do. This deck's not really gonna win on attacking. And this way, if they have a way to make me discard, I won't do it. Many Black Lotuses do I have? I have one. No, I have two. Sorry, I forgot one. Well, I have a collector's edition set, which I don't really, I guess does have a Black Lotus in it, but it's not like, I don't know, whatever. So I have one that I play with. Gonna block Raghavan. Then I'm gonna get to replay it. Well, it's in a box, so it's just like not quite the same. Like, you can't just take it out. Okay. Needle? Interesting. So now, definitely gonna play the Blast Zone. I'm gonna play Needle and. What am I naming with Needle? I think I might name Mishra's Bauble. Because I don't want them to bauble them, to start getting their bauble on. How many Dak Faden? I think I have four Dak Fadens. Because at one point I was playing four of them in a deck. Kroxa is gonna get kind of annoying. I will say that. But I feel like I'll be able to find a Relic of Progenitus off this Urza's Saga pretty quickly here. And I think I'm gonna pump Blast Zone to three. Cause I might kill the Lurrus plus the Ensnaring Bridge, we'll say. Yeah, let's go this. And I think we want Relic of Progenitus. And then I'm gonna play another Saga. Sack the Blast Zone. And I'm at 14. Yeah, well, we'll go ahead and attack here for eight. No. And then don't think I need to crack the relic right now, but I will at some point. Here we go. Here we go. So the reason El Pachi that Mirsha's Bauble is one of the actual strongest cards is because of this guy, this bad boy, Lurrus of the Dream Den. That's one of the reasons. It's a zero mana card that you can play Lurrus and replay it, and it draws you a card. It's also good with Dragon's Rage Channeler because it triggers the Surveil and it enables Delirium. So a lot of reasons for Bauble to be good here. What do I want? I guess I probably want some more relics. Don't care too much about Welding Jar. Needle also seems kind of weak. Hey, Zlubars, what up? I haven't seen Possessed Portal in a deck for a long time. Honestly, that's one of the cards that really piqued my attention. Hey, Faye, I'm not the 30-month Hari Sabrina. Yes, the original companion rule where you just got to cast Lurrus really makes me wonder, like, what is going on over there? Like, what exactly are they doing when they claim they're testing cards? I think I can powder here. And I'll keep this hand. Going for a Tron hand. Yeah, it seems fine. I don't actually want to play Saga yet. I'm going to get to play a Chalice of the Void here. I blew up my Ensnaring Bridge with a Blast Zone. Let's discard Mystic Forge, I guess. I don't know. I have 3 4-drops in hand. It feels like I should discard a 4-drop. Okay, let's play Chalice of the Void for 1. Next turn, we'll play Spellskite, and then we'll play Thought Knot, and then we'll play Karn. We'll go from there. It's my favorite Magic paper format. My favorite Magic paper format largely has been Vintage. I always think it's a real treat when I get to play Vintage. But, yeah, all the old formats are pretty fun. Cake Man, okay. Okay. I'll discard a Spellskite, whatever. Yeah, let's play that. Because if we draw Urza's Mine next turn, then bam. Dothy Voidwalker. Did I ever play against those Italian brothers that were on the Vice Magic Dock? I don't know who those are. Alright, they get to make a 3-3 flyer. Do you open packs for fun or buy singles? Don't really do a ton of either of those, to be honest. Alright, let's get Saga down, because I think we're getting to the point where I need to start doing this. And let's play a Thought Knot Seer, I think. Okay, I'm going to take Dragon's Rage Channeler over Shattering Spree here. Hi, Jules. I just can't really afford to do that. All right. Jules. Good dog. I guess I can't block. I'm at 9. What's my sideboard here? I mean, I guess at some point getting a Relic of Progenitus would be kind of good. Could also play Cookbook. Let's just do Cookbook. Thought Knot. We're giving up Urza's Saga values, sadly. But that's okay. Take the Shattering Spree and hit for 4 here. They get to hit us down to 3. And we'll see what we do from there. They don't have anything else. I go to 3. Is that the land we saw? That was not. Alright, they got Lurrus. Let's see. I'll send an email real quick. So I could discard Karn. Let's see. No, so I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to go untap, draw step, go to main phase. Go get Expedition Map, use the mana. There's a power plant, Urza's Mine. Play Urza's Mine. Play Karn. And reveal, and I have 5 mana left. Yes, I would like to use 2 ability, thank you. Hey, what's up, Nathan in Holland? Welcome. Yeah, I mean, I guess it's just gonna be snaring bridge, and then still gonna, I guess, attack for eight, even though I guess I'm not gonna be doing too much damage after that. Oh, even, I can even gain three life. Oh, wait, I already, wrong one. I can even gain three life, if I need to. Yeah, I don't know who the Martello brothers are, so could not tell you. So they're gonna get to play Lurrus and then play Croxa. All right, so and then gain three life like this. All right, I'll take it. And then now I go back down to three, but I get to Karn again. And then we'll see what I Karn into. Okay. So currently, do I have, what do I have exiled with the void counters? Expedition maps, Eldrazi Temple, Urza Saga. Yeah, that's not a whole lot. Not a whole lot. Oh, okay. Yeah, let's go ahead and play Mystic Forge. Mystic Forge is nice. Then now I'm gonna get, I can also still get a relic off of that. And then the card off relic. Let's go. Boom. This is pretty sweet. Let's get relic. I mean, I could get Torpor Orb. It would mean Kroxa doesn't trigger anymore, so that stops future Kroxas. And what else does it stop? Doesn't stop a whole lot else. But relic also stops. It staying in play doesn't matter. But one reason I want this as well is because it'll also stop the Mishra's Bauble from getting coming back. So yeah, draw that. I could pay a life to exile my top card. I go to two. That doesn't seem like it changes the clock really. Okay, now we can play a map. Oh, nice. Play a Spellskite. Play a land, and I guess I'm just gonna play it safe here. Let's just get an Eldrazi Temple. Discard this to make a food. And then sack that. Oh, I guess yeah, the Karn stops the bauble, sure. All right. We're kind of heating up here. Like they do not have very many turns to draw something to get out of this. Cause I'm gonna have a second bridge in play next turn. And yeah, another Voidwalker's not gonna do anything. Yeah, all right. This is Colossus Tron broken? I feel like we haven't fully answered this. All right, let's play a bridge. Oh, I get to play another Karn. So let's plus one. Actually, let's not even bother plus oneing the Karn. Just play Karn. At some point, I want to get so now they can play a Karn. I guess their Karn can shut off my. That's cute. They could play a Karn, and then I can't play the activated abilities of my artifacts. But I don't think that matters too much. We're getting close to Possessed Portal, yeah. I think what I'm gonna do here is use this and. I think I want to stop the Dothi Voidwalker. So I think Needle's probably the best way. I guess I could have gotten Spyglass. I don't know. Play the third bridge to make a golden one. Yeah. I'm at five, so I can't really get burned out. Dothy Voidwalker. And their number of outs has dropped precipitously, and boom, there we go. Ensnaring Bridge is not the high water mark when it comes to Magic design. Ensnaring Bridge leads to pretty terrible games, to be honest. I don't think it should be banned or anything. I'm not saying that. I just think that like the games where Ensnaring Bridge wins, like, they're not like the most fun if it's doing anything. We have not even come close to losing. No, we came pretty close to losing that last game, actually. There was a Stronghold Precon deck that had Ensnaring Bridge and Bottomless Pit in it. Oh, game design has come a long way. The deck list. Yeah, hold on. I can put it on the stream decker. Ah, that's not what I wanted to do. All right, it's on the doc, the exclamation point deck command will pull it up now. I don't think they're going to bring Ensnaring Bridge onto Arena. Well, that's not sure. They put Brainstorm and Historic for no particular reason. Yeah, Noble Hierarch getting around Bridge is pretty cute here. No Walking Ballista. I wouldn't be surprised if this deck should have a Walking Ballista, but okay. We're on the draw. The exclamation point deck command has the list. Oh, here we go. I have not played Vintage in a little bit. No. Being on the draw is a little rough in Modern or any format, but this is a solid little hand where, I mean, the curve of turn three Karn into Ensnaring Bridge is a pretty real one. Oh, they have no play on turn one. Okay, I guess I like that. Should I have played a Chalice on zero? Serious question. They could be playing like one of those Crashing Footfalls types decks. I'm kind of worried. Feels like I have a lot of outs against everything else. Because if there were a Roggevon deck, they would have had Roggevon or Dragon Rage Channel or Delver or Cantrips. I think I'm supposed to just do this. Like, they could just be Teemer Footfalls so easily. And my hand is really good, so it feels like losing to that stuff doesn't really make sense. Because, like, the way I lose is they play 2/4/4s next turn and then force negation by Karn or whatever. So, I don't know. So, we have Tower and Mine. We need the Power Plant. All right. Let's go Thought Not Seer. Counter spells. Sure. Map. Crack the map. And I think I'm just going to get another Urza's Tower here. Or I could get Urza's Saga. Yeah, actually, let's just get Urza's Saga. That's probably better. The single island is for Spellskite and to get around Void Mirror. Okay, play Karn. Assume this is getting countered. Getting snap countered, sure. I don't really want to play Karn with no blockers here. I will play Saga and play Mystic Forge. Looks like they have a Force of Negation. I can live with that. Okay. All this dust on top of my deck, sure. I mean, if they don't have a way to stop my Tron, like, I guess they could maybe have, like, a Teferi Hero of Dominaria this turn. But we'll see. Oh, Stoneforge Mystic. Okay, that's a clock. Into Cauldra Complete, sure. I don't mind drawing all this dust here. Serum Powder. Do I want to cast a Serum Powder? So it's how much mana do I have? I have. No, I don't think so. What I think I'm going to do is cast Karn. Okay, I kind of didn't mind that because now I can play a bridge, and then I still have Urza's Saga activation. Actually, why don't I just play this instead? I think that that's actually better than making a token. Like, with an Ensnaring Bridge out, I don't think the token is really doing much. I'll probably make a token on my turn, but I don't think so. Okay. Yeah, I think I'll draw this. Yeah, sure. Don't have that much to do here. Hey, Jisuna, just go ahead and go with English, por favor. I guess I'll go with Needle. I'm Stoneforge Mystic. Ooh. Thought not tear off the tizzy. Take that. Okay, they can snap Archmage's Charm all they want. Yoink. Okay, what's my library? Serum Powder. I mean, I guess I will cast Serum Powder into another Serum Powder? Sure. Let's cast our Serum Powders. Why not? Serum Powder boys. Okay, I'll probably Mystic Forge that thing away. Like, I don't really want to draw Eldrazi Temple. I'll pay a life not to draw an Eldrazi Temple here. I think the "is this deck broken" question is starting to get answered. All right. Oh, I didn't actually pay a life to remove that. That's fine. Why not? Ooh, what do you got? What's in that bag? What you got in that bag? Force of Negation? Yeah, I'll take the Force of Negation. Thank you very much. Oh, I guess I actually should have used the Eldrazi Temple mana for Karn. Oh, Cycle or Try, I'm sure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So not enough to get Possessed Portal here. I could get another bridge. I could get Liquid Metal Coating. I don't even know. I guess I'll get Liquid Metal Coating, sure. And then play a land. All right, they had enough. They had enough. Playing against Stoneforge stuff, all his dust seems like it could be good. Torp Orb seems reasonable. What's the win con? Whatever you want. Whatever you so desire. It really doesn't matter too much. I guess Underworld Cookbook doesn't seem all that all that useful. Yeah, I guess we'll try something like this. They cycled there because I was casting a Thought Knot Seer, so they might as well not, they shouldn't cycle before it probably, because it'll just get to take a card out of their hand. They cycled in response because they had nothing in their hand when the Karn was in this deck, tried to fight a Cataract Spell. Yeah. Whatever, consider building a fan-submitted deck, making some tweak, but keeping the theme of the deck and putting it to the test. That's like the sort of thing I would do, like if someone wanted to pay me to do it, I suppose. So yes, I would consider it under those circumstances. Let's just serum powder here. Is this hand good? This hand doesn't seem very good. That's Mulligan. Okay, I like this one more. And let's put in all his Dustus back, I think. What do I charge for sponsor streams? Yeah, it just depends on the circumstances. It's not a one-size-fits-all. Oh, well, hello. Hey, the Dreadlord, the 25-month 30-sub. Oh, I'm loving the dog cam, too. This is just a list I found in the deck list dumps, and so far been pretty impressed. No, my expedition map. I think it'll be okay, though. This is not an Eldrazi, right? Let's go Torpor Orb. It makes my Thought Knot Seers no longer work, but it stops their Snapcaster Mage, so if I played Map and pass, they could snap ending it, and it stops their Stoneforge Mystics. Prismatic Ending is quite the card, for sure. I mean, it's going to be fine here. Oh, Field of Ruin? All right, fair. Do-do-do. Guess I'll do it like this. And I think I'm just going to play Spell Skite. I want to play around Spell Pierce there first. But I don't really want to sack map because I don't know which one to map for yet. Since I only have one drawn PC, kind of want to wait a little bit there. Yeah, there's an Urza's Mine gone. I will say, of all the folks who worked on like Modern Horizons 2 stuff, they came out with like some pretty detailed ledgers of exactly the contributions they made and the changes they made, and that really is not how I tend to approach design, and I don't find it to be a particularly healthy team dynamic. So I'm a little like, I'm not giving shoutouts to people for changing cards. That was their job. Like, I don't know. I always thought that was a little bit tacky. Like, you should be focusing on just making the best things possible, not keeping detailed track of, like, what did I do? Like, obviously it helps you because people are talking about it, so it's, like, smart to do that. But, like, I don't know. That's not how I think you really want to approach those dynamics. Yeah. I'm going to play the Saga now. And I'll play Relic. And I think I'm just going to pass. And they're brainstorming. Jace is a good card. Jace is good against cards like this. Yeah, as Gabby says, it's just, I don't know, that's not really what this is about, but whatever. I am gonna probably crack Relic end of turn and then maybe crack Map. The other thing is, like, almost every design decision and card just goes through so many iterations, so many hands. I would feel uncomfortable trying to take too much credit for some things. It's like, didn't the vast majority of them don't spring from your head fully formed, you know? I mean, I'm not saying it needs to be anonymous either. I felt like there was a lot of trumpeting of praises for, and it's like, oh, as someone who likes to hand it to himself, you know. Oh, deck building is probably more annoying. God, the number of people were like, I invented that deck. I was playing that deck beforehand. Why don't I get credit for this deck? I got 17th on the ladder with mono green elves, and then everyone copied my deck. And it's just like, what are you talking about? Mm-hmm. All right. Planeswalkers are us, huh? Maybe we want more needles. Okay, let's crack this. And I'm just deciding, I guess I have enough mana to use the, yeah, this isn't legendary, right? Hold on. Okay. I have enough mana to use the map, so I was just giving myself another turn to draw a Tron piece to see if I was going to draw one of those. Oh, jewel dog. Now, I get wanting to get credit for things that you feel like you did, and I get a lot of it comes from people who feel like they're not given their full recognition and all that. I can tell you as someone, like, it doesn't... As someone embedded in a lot of different parts of the scene, as like a pro player, as a content producer, as a content employer, it doesn't really come off the way maybe you want. And it depends what an audience you're appealing to. You might not be appealing to me, and that's fine. But it turns me off pretty fast when I see people trying to like desperately grab credit for decks. And like, I've been guilty of this too. I'm not saying I'm not. Like, I've been guilty of all these things, you know, but the design one, not so much. I think I've been... That was beaten to my head pretty quickly when I started work. But it's just, I don't know, it's just tough, right? Like, sure. And you do want people to get credit for, like, cool stuff they did. You want people to do cool stuff. But, like, it's just not that, I don't know, the way it comes off doesn't seem to work out great. Me, gross. Okay. I mean, I assume Irza's Saga is not really going to do the thing. Given that they've got three planeswalkers now. All right, let's make... I didn't realize they had so many planeswalkers, so that is gonna... We're gonna have to go back in the well when it comes to sideboarding here. If they don't have a way to kill this construct... then I can really not even take down their planeswalkers. Bunch of wear tears. All right. Guess I'll take Jace. Sure, I don't even know. Yeah, you know what? I'm not actually going to bother. I really can't construct a hand that would let me win there. So let's keep a needle in the sideboard. But I want a spyglass in. And I want some spellskites out. The chalices also seem kind of medium, and I think I just want more all his dusts. Yeah, this looks a little bit better, I think. Okay. Only one Tron land. No, I think I gotta mulligan this. Okay, I like this. Putting map on the bottom. It's tough because I can get Urza Saga, which is good. But I think I want to play Chalice over the next couple turns. We'll see what they do. Okay. Well, let's play a map. And the next turn, I'll probably play Chalice for two here. I really don't want to play Chalice for one and block my map. That didn't seem like a very good plan. Yeah, they have Snapcaster and Stoneforge Mystic with the both. Sure. Let's just get a Mystic Forge down. Let's just go ahead. Exile the top card. Another Mystic Forge. I don't think I play Chalice for one here. Yeah, Weirtur gets around Chalice pretty easily. Hey, glad you're enjoying Dreamy Pants. Chalice is just not good against their deck. Like, I'm not looking at these Chalices like they're some sort of bomb. Like, I'll probably try to play a Chalice because there are cards in my hand that I should cast. But, like, playing a Chalice for one against their deck doesn't seem very good. They're only one drops Prismatic Ending that I could tell. Yeah, sure. Oh, wow. Okay. Yeah, that's annoying. That is annoying. I didn't know about Alpine Moon. So now they're going to get to turn off Tron. And I'm going to draw a Mystic Forge, and I guess I do nothing. Like, I could play Chalice for one, but it still doesn't seem like it does anything. Yikes. You'd love to hear my thoughts on Commander as a format. I don't know. Like, people ask me that, and I don't really know what to say, because it's like, Commander's obviously like an incredibly fun format a lot of people enjoy, and it's also not something I particularly have a desire to play myself, but I don't really know what I can say that's interesting past that, right? Like, it's like Penny Dreadful. It's like, yeah, it's a format I've heard of that people enjoy. You know, I don't really know what I'm supposed to do about it. The second Alpine Moon, not too bad. Because now one Blast Zone does the trick. Let's go Chalice of the Void for two here. No, they're not playing a card that only stops Urza's Tower. That would be a really bad card. They figured it out that the card does a lot more than that. Have you ever played the board game Diplomacy? I have not, no. I mean, they can Field of Ruin me if they want. All right, Chalice 2 is down. So there are Stoneforge Mystics, I guess they could cast Wear Tear and target Alpine Moon to get around it if you want. Snapcaster Mage and Counterspell are all turned off. Hopefully they don't have too many Planeswalkers going. But last turn, they would have played a Planeswalker. If they had a Jace or something, they would have just played it. How about Wingspan? I played Wingspan once. I think Wingspan's cool. It's a bit crunchy, but definitely seems like a solid game. We did play Diplomacy to decide who paid for breakfast the other day. I did enjoy that. They have a Teferi now. That would be a shame. Alright, let's go for a Mystic Forge. They can go ahead and counter me. Oh, interesting. Spelskite. So, the finals was Sam Pardee and Matt Nass. And we asked Marshall, TBS, and Squirrel in each individually. And, well, Marshall and TBS didn't respond in time, so we went with Squirrel's choice, which was that Sam pays, but two of the three voted for Sam anyway. So, hey, what's up, Kadrick, 17-month resub. Oh, I'm going to exile the Spellskite with Mystic Forge here. But I don't think there's like a big hurry to do it right now, because it's not like I have zero drops I can play anyway. They drew a Jace, which I don't like. That one makes me unhappy. But I'm going to need to find... like, if I find a Needle or a Sorceress Spyglass, that'd be good. If I draw a land and then find a Karn, that'd be good. Oh, Spyglass because of Chalice, sure. I guess that would be tough. Okay. Sure, I'll draw the tower. Knocks out another tower. That's all the towers. There's that serum powder. What do I do here? I think I play another Mystic Forge. I could play the serum powder, but having a second Mystic Forge in place seems... like, it could be nice. Chalice of the Void. Yeah, let's play Chalice for zero. Okay, there's a Karn. Nice. I just played Chalice for zero just to get it off the top of my deck here. I guess they can chase plus two, but if they're spending their time fate dealing me, I'm pretty happy about that. Yeah, we're brawling later. Oh, yeah. Oh, I guess they can't see the top of the deck. Nice, nice. It's good to know. It's good to know. So they have six mana. They haven't used Jace yet. Three cards in hand. Yeah, that's a lot of cards. A lot of access to cards. Oh, wow, they are plus twoing on me. Sure. I guess I should set an upkeep stop. Oh, they left Karn on top. Weird. What's up, Dr. Poop 69? Takes all kinds. Welcome. I mean, if they counter, they counter. I don't really know what I can do. I assume they're going to counter this, but if they don't... I mean, they do have a Celestial Colonnade, but it's going to let me get Needle here. So, presumably that's going to be good. I could also Mystic Forge, but... oh, this looks like a Cryptic. Bouncing a Chalice. Okay. I think drawing Urza's Saga is fine here. Mm-hmm. Okay. Blowing up the moon kills Saga. Oh, they chose Urza's Saga on this. I thought they just chose another Tron land on this. Because I saw Urza's. Yeah, all right. I'll Mystic Forge away the Urza's Saga then. Okay, so the Chalice on 2 was doing good work. Obviously, they did bounce it and then kill it, but yeah, it was getting there. Mystic Forge. Yikes. Yeah, I don't think this is going to be easy to get out of here. The Cryptic Command deck does seem a little tough to beat with this deck, based on what we've seen. Planeswalkers and whatnots. All right, that's enough for me. All right, let's go for round three here. Yeah. They had Alpine Moons, Field of Ruins, Planeswalkers, Cryptics, a bunch of Wear Tears. Did not seem like an easy matchup. And we lost. As those things go. Yeah, Field of Ruins is a solid card for sure. If I drew the third Tron piece deck, it's all as dust. Well, that's not accurate because they had Alpine Moon on the Tron. If I drew an Eldrazi Temple, I could all as dust. Turns out Chalice for One would have been good in stopping Alpine Moon. But I hadn't seen that card yet, so I didn't really want it. And Chalice on two seemed pretty appealing, but I guess I had extra chalices, so I guess, I mean, who knows? The other two pieces each make two. That is not true. It's interesting that people think that that's how Tron works. Why would people put Alpine Moon in their deck if that was the case? I don't know. It's kind of weird. It's like, you have to know enough about Alpine Moon to know kind of what it does, but not enough to know how it works in practice, which is like a kind of weird place to hit, especially given the confidence you need to then proclaim that this is how it works. But like I said before, it does in fact take all kinds. Oh yeah, we'll serum powder here. Nice, and then we'll mulligan here. Let's keep this one. I think I'm gonna put a needle back and go turn one power plant, turn two chalice, and hope that's. Well, we'll see. We'll see what they play on turn one, but I'm probably casting chalice for one on turn two here. Watery Grave. I guess I'm not playing Chalice anymore. Well, that's okay. All right. Mono 4-drop control. What did I exile? Exiled a relic and a bunch of serum powders. Sure. Hey, what up, Diluted Fruitcake? With the 59 months. Welcome back. They're Boblerinoing. And an Eldrazi Temple would be good here. Obviously, an Urza's Mine would also be kind of absurd. Sure, we'll Spellskite, I guess. And then hope to draw a land because we do another 4-drop. Reanimator Tron, I gotta see this, King Dub. Wyrmcoil Engine, Archon of Cruelty, Sundering Titan, Profane Tutor, Boonshars, Thoughtseize, Collective Brutality, Unmarked Grave, but also Map and Tron. All right, yeah, that's pretty funny. Why does this thing look so washed out? Is that just how foils look? That's weird. This is no longer Grixis Death Shadow. It is now Sultai Snow. Grist the Hunger Tide? You gonna make an insect? Okay. Land. Do. Not great. What if instead of a land, I give you a 7-drop? We'll see how this turns out. So this insect has no abilities. It's not like a pest. All right. Ooh, they're getting there. Two snow. Two snows. They just have Luris in their deck? Cool. Okay. Land would still be pretty good here. Hey, that's not even good. All right. Let's see. So we draw Tron piece, we can all is dust, and that's obviously going to do a little bit of catch up, given that they've drawn some extra cards off Bobble Luris. Also, like, good God, a Mystic Forge could be decent here. The cookbook is a life gain mechanism, and then I guess it could get back like a Thought Knots here to get off Saga. The life gain part is actually pretty good against like burn or aggressive decks. Being able to search this up with Saga and gain 3 life a turn off making food is pretty strong. Ooh, they milled 2 non-lands. Nice, I'll take it. Tarmogoyf, sure. Any chance for an AFR draft? Nah, not today. Or probably any day. Grist stuff. I mean, all this dust does seem good. I don't even know if Chalice is what I want. Doesn't sound great against them. I think I'd rather have some relics. And yeah, then that's probably good. We are currently 1-1 with this deck. Down a game in round 3. So we're managing to answer whether this deck's broken or not. All right. Mind map. Yeah, all right. I'll keep. Doesn't have full Tron, but it still has a turn 3 Thought Knots here, which is pretty nice. So I think this is worth it. Yeah, we're asking the important question. That's all we need to do. I would not say this deck is broken. Okay. Let's go Temple. The reason I want to play Temple here is I want to play Thought Knot next turn. And if I'm probably going to crack map for a different Tron piece, just like a Urza's Tower, because I do need to just use my mana and make sure I can hit my land drops. And then that way I can play Tower, and that way I can, the turn after that, I can play Tron. Basically, I didn't want to play a duplicate Tron piece before playing one of the lands, which I know I'm going to have in play. Serum Powder is typically played in broken decks, I'll have you know. So, you know, keep that in mind. This actually looks like a pretty good hand here. And it's Force of Vigor, Grist, Double Snappy. Let's get the Force of Vigor out of here. So next turn, probably gonna play Karn. I use a Logitech webcam for streaming. Oh, excuse me, sorry. It is a 3/4 Tarmogoyf, instant artifact and land currently, though it might be bigger in a second here if they mill something. They did not. They milled another instant. Okay, cool. That means they can't attack. So if I attack, they double block, and I take out Tarmogoyf. Could play Karn. But the problem is if I play Karn, they'll just grist my Thought Knot and attack Karn. So let's play another Thought Knot here. I really don't know what you mean, Oizar. That is not a comprehensible sequence of words. I guess we'll take Ice Fang probably. Or Snapcast. No, I'll take Ice Fang. Play a land. Just pass the turn here. And part of the reason I don't want to trade Thought Knot for Tarmogoyf is at some point I'm going to want to cast All's Dust. So trading a colorless card for a card that dies to All's Dust doesn't seem good. I'm not going to FNM this Friday at the CFP Game Center. I do not live in that state. Oh, I'm going to stream both Magic and Storybook. I don't really know where I got if I gave anyone the impression that I was just no longer going to play Magic. Forgot to play Powder? Did I? No, cost 3. Am I missing something here? Or is it everyone else who can't count? Now, if I just draw a piece of Tron. Oh, so they still have Snapcaster and guess I will play Serum Powder this turn, though. Pass. I need to draw lands is the problem. Inquisition, hey, that takes my bridge. So next turn, I need really any land works for All's Dust because it is an Eldrazi spell. So I need to find that fast. And by fast, I mean literally right now. Because Karn can't get bridge, and though they might use, I'm curious if they're going to use Snapcaster. If they Snapcaster Trophy the Thought Knot, well, they can't do that. They see the face of All's Dust in hand. They could Snapcaster Trophy the Eldrazi Temple, actually. That would be rough. Rabbits, I've bought chickens with Hand of Midas like probably 3 times. It's not great. Okay. And then now they're going to kill the Eldrazi Temple? Maybe? All right, there goes 12 from the Zigoifs. No, they're killing the... Oh, they do not know how this works. All right, any land. Come on, land. I can Karn for a relic, but I don't have enough mana to cast and use the relic. Yeah, it looks like forgetting to play Serum better cost us. No, Tormod's Crypt wouldn't do it anyway. Yeah. Boom. I guess there goes that.